When the Tyne and Wear Metro was constructed, beginning in 1974, it took what had previously been a number of suburban heavy rail lines radiating out of Newcastle-upon-Tyne Central Station and unified them into a single modern light rapid transit system for the region. Of the new infrastructure built to create the metro as we know it today, it's understandable that the flagship sort of showpieces were, and still are, the tunnels and underground stations in Newcastle City Centre and Gateshead, which really made the metro system into a convenient world-class transit system, and of course the Queen Elizabeth II Metro Bridge, which brings the metro lines across the River Tyne in true style. But there was another vital and groundbreaking piece of infrastructure built as part of the project that can often be overlooked, and that's the Byker Viaduct. This 800-metre concrete bridge was built between 1976 and 1979 and carries the east-west section of the Yellow Line out of Newcastle towards Wallsend and the coast. It was designed by engineering firm Ove Arup & Partners and opened in 1982, along with the St James to Tynemouth section of the metro. The viaduct was built in order to take the metro across the steep Ouseburn Valley, and sits between the Ouseburn Railway Viaduct, which carries the East Coast Main Line towards the north, and the Byker Road Bridge. It forms a distinctive S shape as its eastern elevated section crosses the main road and takes the metro down to serve Byker. And this provides riders with incredible views from the train as it rises from underground and snakes its way high across the valley. But it's from down below, within the valley itself, where the viaduct really comes into its own. It towers up to 30 meters overhead. Its concrete legs and spans and graceful curve create a brutally elegant spectacle that never fails to evoke a sense of wonder. The construction is architecturally noteworthy as the first in Britain to use cantilevered concrete sections that were then glued together, and indeed it won a number of awards. But I think that taken on its own merit, the bridge is an architectural and engineering triumph, as its popularity with local photographers and dog walkers alike will testify. The Byker Viaduct offers nothing but stunning views from on top of it and underneath it, all while carrying millions of workers, shoppers, families and tourists to and from the city every year. Proof that beauty and functionality can coexist in perfect symmetry. It's simply a masterpiece.